first question of my sister's behalf. How far is the concept of family planning accepted in Islam?
Sister, the question is that how far is the concept of family planning accepted in Islam? Sister, what do you mean by family planning is important? And the answer is very long. The answer takes several minutes. I'll try and get it short. That there are various types of family planning, permanent method, temporary method, etc. As far as abortion is concerned, the verse of the Quran of Surah An'am chapter 6 verse 151 and Surah Isra chapter number 17, verse number 31 says, kill not your children for want of sustenance, for it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who sustains for you and your children. So, but natural killing of children is prohibited. So abortion is totally prohibited. And permanent method is prohibited, as the Quran says, do not change the physiology of the body. Surah Rum chapter number 30, verse number 30. So permanent method of family planning, like vasectomy, tubectomy, is haram. So based on this, but natural, unless the life of the mother is in danger, all permanent method, abortion, life of the mother in danger, for example, the doctor says that if you have multiple cesarean sections, it will be dangerous for the life of the mother, or the mother has some heart problem. So in these cases where the life of the mother is in danger, if she continues with the pregnancy, then at the last resort, abortion can be done, tubectomy can be done, vasectomy can be done. On the other hand, the other temporary methods we have, the most common is the copper tea. As far as OC pills are concerned, but natural, because it changes the physiology, it should be avoided. As far as the copper tea is concerned, it's the most common. In copper tea, it's not contraception, it's a contraimplantation. Because the ovum and the sperm has got together, zygote is formed, it prevents the clinging of the zygote on the uterine wall, on the womb of the mother. So it's nothing but an early abortion. It's contraimplantation rather than contraception. So again, as I mentioned earlier, abortion is haram. So copper tea also, if you analyze it, it's not permitted. There may be different opinion as far as condom is used or temporary method is used. For example, coitus interruptus. Once a person approached the Prophet and said that I practice coitus interruptus, the Prophet was silent. So one group of scholars say that because the Prophet was silent, it is permitted. The other group of scholars says because he was silent, it is not permitted. So the two groups, as far as the coitus interruptus is concerned, that's breaking the sexual act, or as far as condom is concerned. But what my view is, that let's analyze why does a person want to do family planning. And basically the two reasons. One reason may be that he's too poor, and if he has many children, he cannot give food, lodging, boarding to the children, and he will die as well as his children will die. The other group of people who like to do family planning is because they're rich, they're well off, but they want to make their son a doctor, an engineer. So if I have spacing between them, then more chances I can upbring them better. So the Quranic verse of Surah An'am chapter 6 verse 151 says, kill not your children for want of sustenance, for it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who will give sustenance to you and your children. Surah Isra chapter 17 verse 31 says, kill not your children for want of sustenance, for it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who will give sustenance to your children and you. The verse is the same, but the order is reversed. The first one says, you and your children. The second verse says, your